just made a song about the most ridiculous title.
Hello, everybody.
Welcome to one of my new videos. I want to introduce myself. I am Shayna Cordle. I have had a passion for self-improvement for about 10 years now that I've written extensively on through my own troubles and experiences in life events. I talk a lot about my personal life and it can get really vulnerable. My intention for this interaction between viewer and speaker would be healing, learning ourselves, exploring some uncomfortable topics, diving beneath the surface to really pull out that kernel of truth and that golden nugget that resides deep within each of us. I'm really interested in learning about the self, the higher self, the ego, different personality types, how the self is developed and created, and how our history influences, affects, and changes how we interact with people, how we perceive the future, how we see the past, and how those interactions in turn reflect back upon us to further push us to continue healing or repeating a lesson or whatever we haven't quite mastered yet. And I do believe life is a process. This is a living piece of work that we will forever be working on. This is not something that's just gonna get fixed. This is a journey and it's not about the destination. Life is meant for us to experience and grow and explore and break and grow some more and heal and bond with people and get your heart broken and learn again and fall down and get up and fall down and get up and fall down and get up. It's important that we keep getting up. It's important that we lean in when we don't want to. When things get sticky, when they get hard, when it's ugly and uncomfortable and you'd rather just bury your head in the TV or in a book or mowing the yard and just avoiding. Let's go get food, let's go out to eat. Distract, distract, distract. And that's fine. We all have a right to distraction. It's an important part of the healing process, but it's really important that we also stop and check on ourselves. We spend a lot of time in this world checking on the world, checking on your kids, checking on your business, checking on that email, checking that text, checking the soup on the stove, checking your macros. What did you pick up this time at the gym versus last time? We check the weather. We check what our sister had for lunch today. We are checking on so many things constantly and we disproportionately check on ourselves. I want this place that I'm facilitating and creating here to be a place where you check on you. You can see this as a self-wellness nugget that you can listen to or watch or hopefully read one day. I have to edit it first. That's another video altogether. I want this to be where you put time aside for you. I have to put time aside to prioritize myself, and I want you to do that too. Ask yourself if you've prioritized yourself recently, if you've checked in with yourself recently, and I don't mean just like, huh, is it? Pop, and then that's it. We're done checking in, and we just go whoop, back to that world that we live in with so much noise and speed and stimulation. I want this to be the opposite of that shit. Cause that shit's great. I love it. I love life. Life is amazing and it's wah, and it's in your face and you can't control it. It's wild. It's unpredictable. It's nature itself. The world is incredible and we get to experience it. And it's chaos, but within that chaos is a certain amount of order. And this is something I'll talk about a lot. There's this beautiful balance and dance that plays out between chaos and order. If you pay attention, the sweet spot is right on that cusp. look outside your window and you see a tree, it grows whichever way it wants. It does what it wants. It crops up wherever it wants. It just bees. But there's an order to it. It doesn't grow out of the ground looking like, I don't know, like a book. It grows in a specific order. I am going to be a tree, and this is what a tree looks like, and this is how a tree behaves, and this is what a tree does and doesn't do. Blah, 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 blah. I'm over-explaining here. So the sweet spot between chaos and order, I believe, is where we interact with the world and each other and the universe as a whole. That's where the rubber meets the road, is this spot between chaos and order. The universe is very chaotic, but we as humans really thrive on and crave order and system, and that's evolutionarily evolved. We need that in order to think of the next minute so that we know that we need to pick up food later, or if we're on the Sahara, we have to remember that it's been 5 days since we had a big kill and we really need to send the guys out tomorrow for a hunt, or else we'll starve to death. If we didn't think forward and if we didn't plan, first off, that's a big unique element of humans, is that we have this forward thinking and this ability to both recall back on the past and say, gee, when I didn't plant enough crops, we lost a couple people in the tribe. And so looking forward, I'm going to plant more crops this year than I did last year so that we don't have that happen again. These kinds of decisions, past and future uses to facilitate our evolutionary fitness, laid the foundation for how humans think and process, and how all life really did. On humans, we have that cortex, man, that learned brain. It's not the lizard brain. We have a huge gourd, ginormous. What is going on with that? Okay, there we go, that's better. That was weird. That was like a reveal for my shitty hair. It's getting a little rough at the end, but like, I just don't care, yeah. Okay, I'm going on a rant. Chaos, order, evolution. Evolutionarily, it was advantageous for us to select events from the past and project them forward to protect ourselves from future devastation. That is what the past and future is meant to be. We, in our lives, use it very differently, and we project all sorts of fears onto the future. We kind of pervert the way things were taught to us. But there's this really cool uniqueness about people. So much of our developmental process is done outside of the womb. Humans had to learn how to speak. Should I just jump into it? This would be the thesis right here. Okay, I'm gonna write down. So I did a hello, I did chaos and order, and then I brought in evolution. And now I was going to talk about uniqueness of humans.
The more you know, the more you know, from the rambling overthinker, the rambling overthinker. Jesus Christ.
Cut that out of the video. Am I right?